Today's class is about common types of benign tumors. Common types of benign tumors include adenoma, fibroma, hemangioma, papilloma, lipomas, meningioma, myomas, neuroma, navy, etc. In this class, we will discuss about lipomas. Lipomas are benign tumor of mature fat cell. Before going to the epidemiology, we will see few points about lipomas. Lipomas are the commonest tumor of subcutaneous tissue. They are benign tumors. It's arising from yellow fat. It is also called as universal tumor because of its presence in almost everywhere in the body. It's called as universal tumor because it can be present anywhere in our body. But some exceptions are there. The exceptions include tip of nose, cartilaginous part of ear, brain, shaft of penis, eyelid, etc. Epidemiology. It's commonly found in adults from 40 to 60 years of age. It's also found in young adults. Next, we will go through the types of lipomas. They are encapsulated, diffuse, and multiple. Encapsulated means these lipomas have a capsule, diffuse which is not having capsule, and multiple means they will be more in number. Next classification is according to histology. Histologically, they are of three types: fibrolipoma, neurolipoma, and nevolipoma. Fibrolipoma means lipoma with fibrous tissue. When fibrolipoma is present on a nerve, then it is called neurolipoma. When it is present on a nevi or a mole, it is called nevolipoma. According to the anatomical location, they are of various types: subcutaneous, subfacial, subserosal, intermuscular, subsynovial, intraarticular, submucosal, intraglandular, are some examples. Lipoma may undergo malignant change when present in retroperitoneal, thigh, or shoulder. Clinical features include most of the lipomas are small but can enlarge up to a size greater than 6 cm. They are localized, fluctuating, and mobile soft mass. Lipomas exhibit slip sign, that means they move easily when pressure is placed on them. The skin is free, that means it's not attached to the skin. The skin can be freely moved. They do not exhibit differential warmth. Both the lipoma and the surrounding area will have the same temperature. Treatment of lipoma. Treatment is not necessary until it is painful. If pain persists, surgical excision of lipoma should be done. Some will undergo surgery for cosmetological reason. Complications include myxomatous degeneration. Myxomatous degeneration means mucoid degeneration. Saponification, it's a reaction between fat and alkali. Calcification, infection, ulceration. When lipoma is in the intestine, it can cause intussusception and intestinal obstruction. Differential diagnosis include neurofibroma, implantation dermoid, fibrosarcoma, hernias, papillomas, sebaceous cyst, hematomas, etc. Thank you for listening. Be thorough with the portions. I will come with the next topic. Until then, bye-bye. Take care.